I'm talking country girls and city women, it's your scene.
Gather listeners, she's gonna shout it, gonna sing it, do it her own way.
Walking together on the road, your mama swung her hammer yesterday. Watch my pretty mouth.
And our final speaker, the amazing woman who forged the way for marriage equality in New Zealand, the Honourable Louisa Waller, MP. She is a New Zealand Member of Parliament for Mingaroa. And in 2013, her marriage equality legislation passed 77 votes to 44, enabling two people, regardless of their sex, sexuality, and transgender, to marry in New Zealand.
Nga mana nga leo, nga mana sinua, nga whana gerega, anti dona, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. It's really humbling to be here tonight. I want to congratulate the organisers of this fantastic event. It enables women to come together to share our stories, to celebrate our successes, and do I feel like I've danced on the ceiling? Absolutely. But there's always more dancing to do, and so I want to acknowledge Mayor Clover Moore. I think she's a fantastic leader of this fabulous city. I would like to acknowledge Alex Greenwich and Kenny Sharp, who have been fantastic hosts for me. And I am here for the sole purpose of adding my voice to the Australian Campaign for Marriage Equality. So we don't mind the New Zealand Australians coming over to get married. In fact, one of the benefits of my legislation that we never talk about was the tourism boost and the improvement to our economy. But in all seriousness, I think it's important for this piece of legislation to go through here in Australia because it affirms our place as equal citizens in our countries. And so ensuring our experience in New Zealand, one of the critical things I think that we were able to articulate was that being LGBTIQ actually is a normal disposition. We're not abnormal, we don't need fixing, we're not broken. This is how God made us, this is how our ancestors made us, and this is how we should be. As we are being able to live a life of honesty and truth. And so, if I can share anything, it is that first principle of approach to LGBTI peoples and our place in the world, and obviously within modern democracies, which is what both Australia and New Zealand are, as equal citizens in our country, the state should not discriminate. The state should not discriminate against any citizen. That the person that has an opportunity to make the most difference actually is your Prime Minister. And so I say to Tony Abbott, don't be afraid of the people of Australia, don't be afraid of democracy, enable a free vote in your Parliament, enable our communities to talk about the relevance of creating family, of love and commitment, which marriage is. Enable us to talk to our representatives, our specific members of Parliament, so that they can have a conscience vote about marriage for the communities that they represent. And so I'm really humbled to have been asked to participate not only in this event, but I was at an event on Tuesday night at the New South Wales Parliament. I want to acknowledge Rodney Croom, and I want to acknowledge the Australian Marriage Equality Campaign. I want to acknowledge Albus here today. to get us to where we are now. There's more to do. There's more for us to do. And through working together, I know you will achieve marriage equality here in Australia. I feel like I have achieved something, but then on the other hand, I look at the progressive pieces of legislation that are starting to emerge in other parts of the world. And so my biggest plea is that we, as leaders in the Pacific, work with our Pacific brothers and sisters to ensure that homosexual law reform happens in our region. It's one of the biggest challenges we have. And so if I was to look at another task that we have before us, it would be that. And then just finally, in terms of my commitment to moving forward, I want to acknowledge that the trans and intersex community has been a community that has been the most marginalised. And in fact, in New Zealand, the legislative change that we need to achieve is specific recognition of discrimination to our trans and intersex community, those who represent the gender identity spectrum of the LGBTI family. And they are not currently specifically mentioned in our Human Rights Act, so it's something that I pledge to do, because for me, I think it's easy being a lesbian, I think it's easy being gay, but somebody that's born in a body that doesn't reconcile with who they feel they are, and the fact that they need, in some instances, our health system to be responsive to their needs, is more work to be done by our communities. And so I pledge here tonight that that is the next piece of legislative reform that I will be pushing in New Zealand. And so just finally, let's have fun tonight, let's have fun tomorrow. I think we're beautiful, fantastic people, and actually what I know about Sydney already is that the Sydney that I have come to know embraces our identity. We're incredibly inclusive here, and it's fantastic to celebrate tonight with you. Nō reira, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou.